Welcome back to Eat the Race. This is week 156, day one, beginning of Astra Anima season, as well as Fire and Earth season. We have 30 minutes on the dot to get our match done. So as you can see, we have full lift, so we didn't lose any lift. We'll watch the replays afterwards. Let's go over the teams. So we got Plumeria and Regin, who is our bonus unit. I didn't have time to like grind their bond yet. Summoner support on them, so some of them are just gonna be like C rank. Grima is at A rank because she doesn't take very long. I know I have a system that I use to grind it. Everybody, some of them are just faster because they can player phase. So Fjorm, who's also a bonus unit this week. Wait, is she a bonus unit this week? No, she's not a bonus unit. She will be a bonus unit next week. Well, next rotation. But yeah, we have Bride of Fjorm and Nephil. We have Legendary Claude, Erica, and her brother Ephraim. So this is the Gale Force plus Gravity team. Well, Kanto plus Gravity team. Even though he does run Gale Force. However, on this team, this is my flying team. So a little slightly different sets for this team. And like I said, however, this Ephraim is an Ignis Ephraim. So this is not a Gale Force Ephraim. This is a front Ephraim to cover for Fjorm on the back. I guess he should go with maybe like attack the speed solo, attack speed solo, or death speed solo for this. Just increase his speed, but we should be fine. We still have Nephil for support. We just can't put her next to Ephraim if we want him to be able to double an enemy phase, which is why we bring him. And of course, with Farsafe support and my Farsafe near safe team. Mer is getting closer every day to having her refined, so I will be excited to see what they're gonna do with her. Hopefully they give her mixed phase. She has player facing her weapon, it's just that as a near safe unit, she kind of has to be enemy phase. So yeah, let's see what's in store for us today. We have Apollo, lost lift. Sorry to that you lost lift, Apollo. Not so sorry anymore, since you're just running a nod line. You're not in season, so you're not that dangerous. You're always dangerous because you are Mia. Fjorm, near save. Yeah, I mean, not this team though. We'll go with, I can go with this team. Not this team, where is the other near save? This team, we can go with Grima. We'll put Grima over here and then Fjorm to near, far saver. Veronica, I guess a little annoying, but I don't expect the knots to do too much. Like maybe one will move over here and then the other one will have one, two spaces to move. So only technically one of them should attack Grima. Everyone else will be near safe. I guess the knots stay alive somehow while I get the ether. That's gonna be the ether is gonna be the problem. And if we go with this team, Nats will double, so maybe not. I will go with this team.
Utterly shameless.
I mean, if you, oh, we need to turn on animations and map animations. All right, so you only have, yeah, is just pure offense. So as long as everybody is near safe, it really doesn't matter where anyone goes. So yeah, just stay within near safe range and everything will be fine. I mean far safe range.
It is decided. Choose.
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
There, everybody is in safe range.
I love you.
I think it would be best to put you...
Careful, careful! Let's find happiness.
You can break this and reposition and move out of the way. Not that that matters. I am outside of safety fence, which is good, like actual.
I'll protect you.
Need to be outside of safety fence if I want them to attack. Yeah, I think Niffle there.
Careful, careful.
There, everybody's in.
I'll do it.
Safe range.
Yes. Explain. Lady Niffle.
There, everybody's in safe range. Veronica goes flash. Bye-bye, Veronica. Hello, Leaf. Bye-bye, Leaf.
Huh?
Mia, you're fast and you have damage reduction, but you're not that fast. Trash Heart. Cool. Alright, I still do have to be careful with the knots, because one of them moves increases the range of the other. So technically the range is right here as it is. This is this knot's range. If this one moves over here, this one will get 1, 2 and be able to move over here. So
who dies first?
You move here, 1, 2 hit the spot, so
I love you.
We are safe on that front. We do need to be careful on other fronts. Again, if you move here, she will move 1, 2 and
yes,
be able to reach Niffle.
Yes.
So we don't want her to reach Niffle right now. Here, 1, 2. Basically, you can move 3 spaces. Let's just say 3 spaces. 1, 2, 3, hit here.
I won't lose. Close your eyes. It is decided.
Once we get rid of one of them, the other one is easier to maneuver.
Let's find happiness.
All right.
Over here?
You do 40 damage to her.
Yeah. Explain.
How do I not get killed by you?
I won't lose.
Because I can kill this one.
Yeah.
And then move up here. Away from this one, Strange. But...
why not?
You're not in the best spot for it. And I kind of need you guys to hit something. Fjorm would have been the better choice. You're the slower one, so... you're the fast
yes.
one. But Niffle is way faster than you.
Choose.
So is everybody. Literally everybody, just because you didn't I have fortress advantage.
I'll do it.
You are not gonna take a hit, though.
Close your eyes.
And you don't have Wings of Mercy either.
I won't lose.
Regan might kill you in retaliation as well. Especially this one. I don't want to lose Aether early in the week. That'd be dumb.
Yeah.
So how can I do this?
Over here?
I can kill this one with Regan and then have Regan move over here out of the way. That will mean that Plumeria will be safe and you guys are chasing after Plumeria. I can put Regan right here, so next turn I can reposition her over here onto this trap. If it's the real one, I can use Regan to reposition Fjorm over here.
It is decided.
Alright, so you have to die.
I'm going to stop you.
Alright.
Yes. Explain.
Wish I could reposition you.
I'll do it. Yes. Lady Niffle, who dies first?
I need two turns to be able to get that ether.
Close your eyes. Yes? I'll protect you. Choose. It is decided. Why not?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Over here? Yeah. Who dies first?
All right.
I won't lose. Careful, careful. Explain, Lady Niffle. I'll do it. Yes. I'll protect you.
All right.
Let's find happiness.
The ether.
Yeah. Explain.
Get the knot. So yeah, like, even if, like, we had fortress advantage, but it didn't actually matter at all.
Freeze.
It was just maneuvering the knots to be able to get the pots. But yeah, I mean, there wasn't really much to that team. It was just armor units. I mean, cavalry units that get easily taken out by Ascended Fjorm, especially because their whole flash strategy doesn't work. All right, so now that that's done, we can take a look at the defenses. And we have three to go over. So two successes and one failure. This one came in just outside of it. See, if it had come in like an hour later, it would have counted and it would have given us that 20-hour protection. We should still have plenty of time before we get hit that counts, but... So let's take a look at against RDT, Reddit, I guess. I don't know what RDT stands for. So for this one, I had not switched out my team. So technically, they have Fortress Advantage, a plus one. And Ryoma is not getting any kind of buffs because he's out of season. Everybody else is fine. So technically, this would have cost me the 60 points had I lost it. But let's take a look at what they brought. They've got a Regan with double Swift Sparrow reposition. Tethys with Temari, Fury, Wings of Mercy, double drive rest. Luna. Ninja Lin. Reposition, disarm trap, life and death. Naga, life and death, drive speed, speed death link, smite. Olivia, rising light. Okay, and AoE attack without. Okay, I don't know. Why does she have an AoE attack, and why is like the base version, not the the prerequisite. Wings of Mercy, Guidance, and Air Orders. And their second Ninja Lin with Wind Sweep, Reposition, and Deathblow. And that's gonna cost them actually, that Wind Sweep. Start by getting rid of some stuff. Get their Ninja Lins ready. They do have one with disarm trap, so. Alright, Regan takes out Ryoma. Again, this Ryoma is not getting any kind of mythic buffs because he's out of season. And they don't have any, I don't have any dancers, so. From here on, have Regan take out Ines. Alright, and then Tana move a little too soon. Regan takes Atrasir. They gamble on a trap and fail. Because that one was not the one with this on trap.
Prepare yourself.
Take a leave. And take out Tana.
Think you can beat us? Think again.
Self-dance so they can get Regan out of the way. And then of course my team's stalling. And this is, remember, Wind Sweep, so. And then again, Seiros.
Prepare yourself.
Does not get the kill.
Lin, I'm not sure I can. Courage, Florina.
Could not get fully out of the way. And Ike has either charged, so.
And this.
Not
And then we already know that Lin cannot kill Seiros in one run of combat.
This is it!
Yes! What she said! Lin, you're a wonder!
Accept your punishment!
And then, again, windsweep.
You're finished!
Lin, you're a wonder! Prepare yourself!
And that's it. I mean, they couldn't take out Ike because they really didn't have the firepower to do it. Usually the only way Ninja Lin's killed my Ike is after he gets hit by Bolt Tower. Alright, here I had already fixed the team. Got a cavalry school in and I switched out Ryoma for Grima. So, don't have fortress disadvantage, but they got a Naga. Plus two with Fury, Smite, Defer Sling, and Death Tactics. Regan, plus four, plus five with Blaze Session, Reposition. Plumeria, Wings of Mercy, Attack, and Rest Tactics, Mumbo. Plus four, plus 15. Mikaya with Reposition, Iceberg, Attack, Rest, Solo four, Nora Follow Up, Attack, Smoke, and Mystic Boost. And near save Gustav, close defense and steady breath with Ignis. And finally Flame with speed rest form, physic, and distant guard, close guard. Test the trap and put her set up near safe. Tana goes in, as Tana will always do. Yeah, there goes Mikaya. Cannot one-shot leave, but with color replaced. Advantage.
This is the end.
And they're still within flame damage reduction, so. Not to mention Mikaya has her own damage reduction against range.
Don't get in my way.
Yeah, that would have done a lot more damage without a flame. And unfortunately, one of Ike's big weakness is slow tanks. Slow tanks really do a number of on bike. And then Ignis plus Dragon Effectiveness. And still didn't do that much damage. Now Grima would have survived this iceberg had she not been hit by a Bolt Tower. And yeah, you're not gonna initiate on Ike. This time we do even less damage than before, probably because the buffs and debuffs. But even though she does have no follow-up, it doesn't really matter because Out of my sight. Trasir also has prevent follow-ups from enemies, so. From here, Trasir just keeps doing her thing.
Rest in peace.
And then Ines moves in right in front of the tower. Bait with Gustav. But unfortunately for them, they don't really have a way to get the other pot.
Know the strength of Asker.
And I'm assuming Micaiah could not kill him. I guess she would have hit him and activate his special, and then since his special goes through damage reduction, her Thorny would not have activated. Flame would not have activated. That's why they didn't initiate combat on him with Micaiah. So technically, the only way that they kill him was to get Gustav to get his Ignis ready. And then we have Connor. They got Rayson with no special Fury, Wings of Mercy, Dry Speed, Aerobatics. +2/+4 Altina, Fortress Death Rest, Wings of Mercy, Reposition. Ashera +3 with Smite, Speed Deafening, and Death Tactics. Regen +2, Double Swift Sparrow drawback. Flame, HP attack 2, Drive Rest, Drive Attack. And a +2/+14 Summoner supported Hector with Bonfire, Special Fighter, First Save, and Mystic Boost. So another save team. I mean, we use save today as well, so. Fans was still active, so. Here they did not see it, but this is what's gonna happen. I go in, of course.
Pierce the sky, Multet.
And then Tana just jumps in, bypasses Hector, and takes out their flame.
Just you wait, Mother. Soon.
And now that Hector doesn't have flame again, remember Trasir has no follow-up, partial follow-up, but what it does is they no longer have flame, cannot heal Hector. Hector is now outside of special fighter.
Fool.
Ashera of course one shot Tana because Ashera can get a lot of attack power out of nowhere. And here comes Ines. Again, no special fighter, so no bonfire.
Fool.
And our kid Ines takes out their Hector.
I must be ruthless.
And Leaf is ruthless because he just one shots Altina. And then I barely misses the kill on Ashera. And that's it. They lost 3 units. Don't really have a way to kill Ike now. If the Regen had Hardy Bearing, she would have been able to kill Ike, but I don't know why people don't run Hardy Bearing. And that's it. We got less than a minute before it turns over to the next day, so let me actually see if there was anything to summon before it goes away. Another 7 days. Nope. Okay, so nothing that needed immediate summoning. But we can steal someone this. We'll go for Noe, of course. If not, then we'll go colorless. Hopefully we can get a Noe. I would like to merge mine. Nah, it's just a stall. Trying to stall for time. Do I know it is worth it? Let's go. We'll just know it. That's it. Can we get lucky? Nope, we get a 3-star. Wings of Mercy. And gold flyers again. That's mostly what I use it for, gold flyers. Or war flyers, actually. So, that's pretty much it for today. Let's actually see how you guys did on day one. See if anybody lost life or... Alright, so Logan is in first place today. Gabs, Ukisu, Kako, Michael, then we have ECLA, Aurum, Darkluster, Brave Blitz, Lambrest, Neo Swordsman, Kenny, Diego, Promise, Silver, Matt, Dux, Amethyst, and Bean, and Brandy. Yeah, I think that is everybody from Friendless, and that's it. So thank you all for watching. Until next time, bye. Oh, actually, no, sorry. I did forget one thing. We do have the new banner now. We know who the new ninja banner is. And for some reason, the video is not here. It wasn't easy to see in the... There it is. All right. So, yeah, we have more ninjas with very similar weapons as last year ninjas, except with... well, the bow, yeah. We have a bow with Shinon. So Shinon is going to be a archer, obviously. But he has the same as last year's weapons, I believe. There's only one weapon that is the same as last year's. The brave weapons with lower your... give you speed, lower your attack and defense. He has the Ninja Yumi. We also have Male Corrin with the variation, the Ninja Yari, which is this one doesn't give you speed, but it gives you true damage. Same as our duo hero, which is a mage cavalry, and basically she's just Ninja Lin. Duo Corrin and Elise is basically Ninja Lin on a horse with magic. They're basically the same type of unit. Have auto refresh, brave weapon, literally the same unit, except Lin hits physical, Corrin is going to hit magic. But for the most part, they're basically the same unit. The last unit we have is... Who was the last unit? We have 4 units. Male Corrin, Shinon, Duo Corrin. I'm forgetting one unit. Oh, well. Oh, yeah, yeah. Igren. Igren, who is also a... Who is a flying dagger. Actually, Igren is the one that has last year's weapons. The +4 speed, -4 defense, -4 rest. Shinon has the Yumi, which is just the true damage. Corrin has the true damage, both male and female. And our free unit is... name. Excuse me. He's literally ringing here somewhere, but I... Shamir, for some reason. Cannot remember Shamir's name. Yeah, Shamir. Attack rest form. And War Beast, Sacred Seal. Not the best Sacred Seals. Tigress Form is good, but War Beast is very situational. The next and final event, the series of Tattle and Ice and Flame. So this should be the one with Ascended Legion. So yeah, this should be Ascended Legion. The next and final event in the series is the Ice and Flame. It's scheduled version 6.0 because the Ice Sotra series events. You will be able to view the story of the Tempest Trial Plus event page and the event. Is even if you didn't participate, this does not apply to Tempest Trials Plus events that are not Ice and Flame. Basically, just like you can rewatch that story once it's over. Let me see if we have Shamir's kid over here. So Shamir comes with the dagger, the true damage dagger. Glimmer, attack speed 2, and attack speed off. So we're finally getting an off skill. But attack speed 2, do we really need attack speed 2? This is our bonus unit with Shinnon, Elise, female Corrin as the free units that you can use. Well, as the Tempest Trial units. But yeah, so that's the banner, the ninja banner. That's it. The weapons are not very exciting because they're very similar to last year's. They do have the true damage based on speed, so that is something. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.